So when the offense possesses the disc near the sideline, we are near the sideline we're forcing towards, we're often going to want to apply a sideline trap. The objective of the sideline trap is to make throws back towards the center of the field very difficult or dangerous for the offense. So we set up a sideline trap initially in a very flat way. So the initial position of the marker is to take away these direct throws back towards the middle. Once the stall reaches 5, or in case somebody yells at the marker, dump, 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 because somebody's gotten open down here, or even if not, but once it's reached stall 5, the marker is going to shift over and take away the dump. This allows this defender to focus on the strike cut. Often when you're like this, this guy jukes back and forth, gets open one place or the other, because you can only cover one direction for so long. Now the marker, or this defender, will worry about the strike cut, and the marker's taking away anything. If he does get open for the dump, it's going to have to be straight back and stay on the line where we can keep a sideline trap going. So he's forcing this way. The temptation for this thrower now becomes, so, and it's this one important concept here is this defender does not let the offensive player take the inside track. You always stay inside, either forcing a difficult throw into space for this person to run on, which we'll accept if they can do that consistently, or to throw a tough inside out break to here. All defenders in the stack then are going to be fronting here and be aware. This guy runs here, you're going to look for that inside out throw.